teachers and friends, let's stand up and praise the Lord.
Yeah. Hi boys and girls, good morning. Come, let us close our eyes and let us pray. Dear God, we thank you for allowing us to meet this morning. Help us, Lord, to open our hearts to hear your word today. Help us to focus on you always, Lord. And we want to be faithful to you always. Thank you for all the blessings that you showered on us, Lord. All this we give thanks and pray in Jesus' name. Amen.
Let's review the Bible story that we have heard 2 weeks ago. Do you still remember what was the lesson about? It's about faithfulness to God and trusting that God will help us to be faithful to Him. Let's check out how much you could remember. Which book was the story taken from? Yes, it's from the first book of the Bible. It's called the book of Genesis. Who was the main person in the story? Yes, it was Joseph. Who is Joseph? Joseph is the son of Jacob, and Joseph has 10 older brothers who was very jealous of him because Joseph was their father's favorite son. We could see the beautiful robe that his father gave to him and not to his brothers. Besides that, God also gave Joseph dreams. And when Joseph told his brothers about his dreams, his brothers got even angrier at him. Their brothers' jealousy and anger prompted them to cause harm to Joseph, and they sold him into slavery. Joseph was sold to work in Potiphar's house. Potiphar's wife accused Joseph for something that he didn't do, and Potiphar put Joseph into jail. After some years, the king of Egypt, Pharaoh, had strange dreams that no one could tell the meaning of his dream. Then the cupbearer remembered Joseph, and Joseph was brought into Pharaoh. With the Lord's power in him, Joseph was able to interpret the dream of Pharaoh. God gave special favor to Joseph. And Joseph told Pharaoh that there will be 7 years of abundance in the land of Egypt, and then followed by 7 years of famine. Famine means there will be no rain and nothing could grow, and everyone will have nothing to eat. Then Pharaoh promoted Joseph and put him in charge of his palace and the people. Now when Joseph's brothers came to him from Canaan, because the bad famine affected Joseph's family in Canaan too, his brothers were sent by their father to go to Egypt for food. They didn't know that they will be seeing Joseph alive and face to face with Joseph. When they were in Egypt, Joseph saw them, and Joseph recognized that it was his brothers who sold him into slavery. Now Joseph could have taken revenge by not giving them food or anything to eat or by arresting them. But instead, Joseph forgave and finally he reconciled with his brothers. Joseph was faithful to God. Joseph chose to do the right thing that will please God. He gave them food and forgave them for what they had done to him. Looking at Joseph's life, do you know who was with him during his tough times? God. All that Joseph had gone through, whether good or bad, God helped Joseph to be faithful to him. Joseph didn't have an easy life. Remember, he was badly treated by his very own brothers, and he was sold to Egypt to work for other people. Not only that, he has to be so far away from his family members. While in Egypt, He couldn't be his father's favorite son anymore. And his life in Egypt was not an easy one. He was even sent to jail for something that he didn't do. But Joseph was faithful to obey God, and Joseph was rewarded for his faithfulness to God. Joseph chose to do the right thing. He chose to love and forgive instead of acting according to how he feels, because he knows that obeying God and doing what pleases God helps him to be faithful to God. More importantly, Joseph trusted God to help him to be a faithful Christian. So boys and girls, from the story of Joseph, we could also learn to be a faithful Christian when things get tough. You know, when things get tough, we can always choose to either act according to our feelings or to choose to do what pleases God. When we choose to do what pleases God, this will help us to be faithful to God. And we can always ask God to help us whenever we struggle to do what God wants us to do. We can come to God in prayer and call out to God, and God will send His Spirit to strengthen us in Jesus Christ and to help us in our tough times. So children, let God help us to be faithful to Him. Let's say the PowerPoint message together. God will help me to be faithful to Him.
Okay, hello children. Look at this. I'm sure you know what is this, right? It is the fan. Now, when it is not connected to the power source, so it is not working. Now, let's see. If I connect it to the power source, see what will happen to the fan. Look. Yeah, the fan is working at full speed and you feel cooling, right? So now, right now the fan is working at full power and full speed. Now, watching this fan work reminds me of how when you and I are working with the Lord and His power is working through us, things go well. Okay, now, what will you do when problems comes along? Do you pull back and let the problem flow instead of letting the Lord's power flow in you? Some people pull back a lot. They let their problem rule instead of letting God's rule in their lives. Some people even go so far, they blame their problems on God. In some cases, some people will disconnect themselves from God. But don't do it. Don't quit. Stay connected. Jesus will carry you through tough times. He will restore you and recharge you. Jesus wants God's Spirit moving through you. Stay connected to your strength and power source, which is Jesus. Jesus will make you strong in the tough times and give you the power for victory. Now, just as our PowerPoint says, God will help me to be faithful to Him. So, don't disconnect yourself from the power source.
Hi children, do you enjoy today's Sunday's lesson? Okay, now come to the end of today's lesson. Let us pray. Our Father in heaven, You are almighty, wonderful, and marvelous God. Thank you for today's lesson. In life, we may experience good things and bad things. When bad things happen to us, Lord, help us do not give up. Because we know that we are not alone. And Father in heaven loves us and will take care of us. Dear Lord, you will make a way for us to overcome our problem. When we have done something wrong, Lord, help us to repent and change to a better person. As a Christian, we must have faith in God. And God, help us to be faithful to you. Learn to forgive others and love others. Just like Joseph forgave his brothers and loved his brothers. Thank you, God, for providing us what we need. Wherever we are, thank you, God, you are always with us. We will never be alone. Thank you, everything, in Jesus' precious name. Amen.
We have come to the end of our Sunday school lesson for this year. Sunday school video lessons will be taking a break in the month of December. Join us back on the 9th of January, year 2022, for our Back to Sunday School event. Do keep in touch with your small group teacher. See you again next year. Bye-bye.